Good evening, guys. Welcome back to the 254 Node, where we speak on matters on cryptocurrencies and investment with a difference. I hope you had a lovely day, guys. I hope you are back to your houses, you're safe and sound, and ready for another video. When it comes to making money off cryptocurrencies, there currently exist several ways to do this. Each method comes with its own challenges and complexities. The simplest method to date has been to HODLING, whereby all you need to do is to make a purchase of your crypto asset, be it Bitcoin or other altcoins, and simply hold on to them in your crypto wallet. Bitcoin trading is also another method through which you can make some extra cash using your cryptocurrencies. That being said, it takes time and mastery in order for you to become a full-time trader. It is both lucrative when done properly as well as risky if it is done in a rush. Today we shall be looking at a third method through which you can earn off your digital assets. This method is simple to set up and run, but it can also be complex in some instances. But for the purpose of this video, I shall try and simplify it as much as possible. The method I am talking about is none other than staking. It is a great method of making money off your cryptocurrencies, as it can be done passively as you engage in other activities. As far as the Bitcoin network is concerned, it is kept secure and running by miners who validate transactions through proof of work, whereby they use specialized cryptocurrency mining machines to mine for Bitcoins. This is done by solving complex mathematical equations, but this isn't the topic of the video. Proof of work, commonly referred to as POW, has the advantage of decentralization, but it comes at a cost. As we know, nothing has positives only. These computers combined take up as much power as small countries such as Singapore. The dark side of proof of work is that it uses up large sums of power, which is detrimental to the environment, especially if mining is conducted in regions where electricity is derived from non-renewable alternatives such as coal and gas. Proof of work is also capital intensive, as the computational power required for mining proof of work network coins such as Bitcoin and Ethereum increases with each mining difficulty increase. This leads to the need of better, faster, more expensive mining equipment. This is where proof of stake or POS comes into play. Numerous proof of work projects are now looking into implementing proof of stake algorithms into their protocols. The largest one at the moment is Ethereum, with its Constantinople and St. Petersburg upgrades, which will allow for staking on the Ethereum network. Unlike proof of work, you do not have to run any specialized computers to mine for cryptocurrencies. Thereby, proof of stake is environmentally friendly. It also means that more and more people can participate in securing the network and thereby creating more interest in the crypto space. In simple terms, think of staking as earning dividends on your shares, or by being paid interest on the money you have locked in your fixed deposit account with your local bank account. In order for you to stake most POS cryptocurrencies, all you need to do is to hold a certain amount of coins, which are the bare minimums, in a wallet, and you get paid in return for doing so. It is a win-win arrangement for both parties. As an investor, you get to be paid for securing the network by validating the transactions. Currently, Binance, the largest cryptocurrency exchange, offers staking. You can stake VeChain, IOST, Tezos, BNB, which is their native Binance coin, and so forth. This is ideal if you are a long-term trader and leave your coins on the exchange. That aside, I would not recommend leaving any of your coins on any exchange for obvious reasons. You can stake on both desktop as well as mobile wallets, depending on the different projects. Some require you to leave your wallet open 24/7, while others just need you to hold your coins in the wallet. With the current prolonged bear market, you can get into staking at an affordable price. Most coins are down 80 to 90% off their all-time highs. This can be lucrative as you are paid for holding onto the coins as you await for the bulls to come back into town. In full disclosure, I am currently staking EOS, VeChain, Navcoin, PundiX, Redcoin, and IOST. Below are some other projects that support staking as well. Stakingrewards.com is an immensely powerful tool. If you are looking into staking, it gives you lots of information such as the complexity on the setting up the staking, the bare minimum and the cost for each and every single token, that is if you want to stake, as well as they give you an overall score on how the project performs. So thank you guys so much for watching my video once more. I truly hope that you have found value in this video. If so, please consider sharing the video with your friends, with your family, and let's get the word out about cryptocurrencies and the potential gains that they offer. If you want to support the channel, please consider subscribing to my channel. I upload videos at least once every week, and I would appreciate if you would leave a like and a comment as to what you found interesting about the projects that I have just listed right now. Thank you so very much for watching. Consider subscribing once more and catch you guys on the next video. Thank you so very much.